bustling with activity. This is Nairobi's Eastleigh suburb. It's known here as Little Mogadishu. Eastleigh is inhabited mainly by ethnic Somalis from both Kenya and Somalia. A cloud of anxiety has engulfed the district since the Nairobi mall attack.
Every conversation here is about what might happen to us. We had no role in the attack. We fear the worst.
The claim by the Somali group Al-Shabaab that it was responsible for the attack at the mall has heightened this community's fears. They are concerned that harassment could come from either members of the public or the Kenyan authorities who've in the past been accused of targeting ethnic Somalis in security operations. The worries of this community are not unfounded. Memories are still fresh of the mobs that targeted Somali homes and shops in Nairobi last November after a suspected Al-Shabaab attack on a minibus killed 9 people. Yet the community has joined the rest of the nation to show their solidarity with the victims of the attack. Here, Somali leaders discuss another round of collecting funds and food for the victims. They have also been fighting claims that they have not been forthcoming with information regarding criminals living in their midst.
The community always reveal identities of people who are dangerous. They give enough information to police, but these are classified information. Somebody cannot run around and say, I have information on Al-Shabaab.
The member of parliament for the area, Yusuf Hassan, himself a victim of a grenade attack that killed 2 people in Eastleigh last December, has been trying to reassure his worried constituents.
We now have a new constitution. We have a new government whose vision is very different. And as the president said, terrorism was the problem. It had nothing to do with religion or any ethnic group. There wasn't going to be any retribution or backlash against any community. We are all one, and I want to believe that.
For now, the hopes of Kenya's Somali community rest on how different the policies of the new president will be from those of the past, where they appeared to be collective punishment for the crimes of a few. Mohammed Adow, Al Jazeera, Nairobi, Kenya.